This spot is so good, most of you have no idea how good it is. I mean, I know that most of you are excited about it because there's some obvious things to get excited about. But when this video is done, your mind will be blown. The knowledge of comic books and also American sitcoms is stunning. And again, this is in 30 seconds. I can't believe it. Look, in the reaction, one of the first things I asked was, is this gonna look like a movie or a TV show? And you know what? To my absolute delight, the answer is, it looks like a comic. That's amazing to me. You know, Feige has never had the time to tell these stories with the details of the comics. Movies just don't allow it. And as a result, I think with the exception of Endgame, which was 3 hours long in order to accomplish that, you know, the Marvel stuff has seemed a little vanilla. It hasn't gone into the details that we've wanted. It hasn't seemed as sophisticated. But apparently, the ability was there all along, and they just needed the time. I mean, if this, you know, Watchmen, by the way, I keep bringing up Watchmen because you should watch it. But that is a show that had multiple episodes that was allowed to act like a comic, to tell that depth of story. And I see that potential here. And it's like, you're doing it. It's so exciting. And for Marvel, of all people, to be the one to do this, you know, it's like, imagine if you could get, you know, a lot of us to watch Joker. Like, Joker would be a really great first two episodes of a series. And then you could go and you could see what happens to Batman coming around and you could explore all that. But we're going to have to wait maybe for a trilogy. You're going to get this in the span of a few months, or like 2 months. That's just amazing. I just can't believe it. All right, so we're gonna break this down shot by shot. But first, they sent me in a press release a little bit of information about each of the three new shows and their release dates, their official release dates. Well, they're not exact. So for Falcon and the Winter Soldier, it says, following the events of Avengers Endgame, Sam Wilson slash Falcon, Anthony Mackie, and Bucky Barnes slash Winter Soldier, Sebastian Stan, still employed after you know, pulling a bit of a John Boyega on Twitter the other day, team up in a global adventure, this is hilarious, that tests their abilities and their patience. Wah, wah, hilarious! In Marvel Studios, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. The all-new series is directed by Kerry Skogland, Malcolm Spellman is the head writer, and it debuts on Disney Plus this fall. So it's not going to quite make the August date that had been promised before. Well, actually, Disney Plus never said that, but that's what Deadline, I believe, had reported. But Disney Plus is now saying in the fall. WandaVision, the real star of Disney Plus, let's be honest. Marvel Studios' WandaVision blends the style of classic sitcoms with the Marvel Cinematic Universe, in which Wanda Maximoff, Elizabeth Olsen, I like having these comic book characters and their alternate identities and the actor playing them all listed here. Like, it's normal for us, but it's funny having like non-comic book readers have to do all this. So Wanda Maximoff, Elizabeth Olsen, and Vision, Paul Bettany, two superpowered beings living their ideal suburban lives, how cool is that, right? Begin to suspect that everything is not as it seems, right? The new series is directed by Matt Shankman. Jack Schaefer is head writer. It debuts on Disney Plus this year. No specific time period, you know, like month. Loki, in Marvel Studios' Loki, the mercurial villain Loki, Tom Hiddleston, resumes his role as the god of mischief. I think he never really quite made it there, but I think in the series he might. In a new series that takes place after the events of Avengers Endgame. Oh, wait till you see what this teaser reveals. Kate Herron directs and Michael Waldron is head writer. Debuts on Disney Plus next year, 2021. So, as I said in my Disney Plus update, I hope you'll check that out, link down below. I've heard that the Loki show will lead into Thor: Love and Thunder because of the timing. And, you know, maybe to some degree, you know, Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, but it's much further along than these other shows. All right, let's break this down. You're gonna, as I said, prepare to have your mind blown. All right, I'm so excited to share this with you. All right, so here we go. So I love the throbbing music that came in over this. This was just amazing. So, you know, clearly he's practicing with the shield, right? A little bit like Ray in the woods, but he seems to have gone home. You know, Sam Wilson's gone home. It's obviously the American South. And I think that it's extreme. It's like a comic book with the way the panels are done. Oh my God. I think it's incredibly iconic that to reach into the Captain America shield are the hands of an African-American man. That's like right out of Watchmen right there, boy. I mean, this is amazing. I love it. It's so powerful. And I do think they're going to do what I talked about in my U.S. Agent first look video. And that's that the U.S. government's going to be like, we don't think, and that's directly from the comic, we don't think America is ready for a black Captain America, which is, I don't know how they can make that argument in 2020. We'll see what the show decides. But I think that's something along the lines that they're going to do. And as I said, Watchmen had a lot of problems with that. We'll see how people react to that storyline here. But that, to me, it is so much like a comic book, like the panels, right? Oh, I love it so much. Okay, read comics. So look at that. Oh, nice form, Sam. So he's practicing. I think his target's pretty good. I would love to see, I hope that, because you know it's Marvel, they have the comedy. I'd love to see a couple throws where it totally misses it, goes into the trees, goes into the ground. Hilarious, you know, if I were to throw it. You know, at least the first couple of times, I'm sure I'd get there too. All right, so I love it. I just think it's so cool that he's practicing. Like, I'm like, it's time. And I'm like, oh, this is so great. I just absolutely love it. It's a little bit reminds me of the Monica Rambeau scenes, or Maria Rambeau scenes in all these things have the same kind of sound. Captain Marvel. But it's just so cool. I just love it. He has a more of tropical setting, as you can see from some of the foliage there. But it's so cool. I'm like, don't take it away from him. Look how hard he's practicing already. It also reminds me a little bit of Captain America chopping wood, right? But Sam's not flexing quite like Captain America did. All right. So look at that. That looks like a movie. You know, so we started like, what kind of action sequence? I can't believe they paid for this I'm sure the whole crew was like, and this is for a Disney Plus show? And they're like, yes, a Marvel Disney Plus show. And they go, oh, say no more. So they're like, what can we do with Falcon? I know. So they have those cool, like, bat flying suits, right? So there's some kind of midair heist. Again, I'd love it if one of these were Tom Cruise. He just pops up everywhere. He's like, everyone's doing my extreme sports thing. Damn it, I'll have to top myself. I have no doubt that Tom Cruise can find a way to top all this. He just, you know, there's a funny, Matt Damon has told this on some talk shows. There's a funny Tom Cruise story where he wanted to do a stunt. And he said, the stunt guy said it was not safe and he couldn't allow me to do it. So then I told the new stunt guy. So he just basically was like, Tom Cruise was like, so I just hired someone who would do what I want, would let me do what I wanted. And it's so unsafe and so irresponsible, but it's amazing. All right. So look at that. That's the most, like, wow. You know, like, there's the funny thing, you know, How It Should Have Ended did that when Captain America Civil War, when, you know, Steve held the helicopter and then Bucky looked out the window and was like, too sexy, and crashed the plane. I mean, the helicopter. That's Bucky's too sexy shot. I mean, that also looks like, look at the cheekbone, like the look at the face and the cheekbones. It looks right out of a comic book. Usually you don't see that kind of face definition unless someone drew it. I mean, it's just amazing. And like, they're having a pop collar off here. They're like, who wore it better? I'm like, I don't know. I think it's the tie guys. You both look fabulous. And the haircut's really working for him. Oh my God, it's just so great. Ah, these secondary characters. You know, John Boyega said, back to John Boyega, you ain't gonna Disney Plus me. Being Disney Plus is starting to look pretty good. These second rung MCU characters are like surpassing almost to some degree, I think, a little bit the big screen people in terms of like coolness and detail and a story. I mean, it's just amazing. So look, so Baron Zemo's like, I'm gonna get you later. You know, like, so he's like, oh, I could have shot you, but all the bullets are in my other hand. Maybe he's gonna be like, my hand's the real bullet. I could punch a hole right through you. And he could. Baron Zemo's like, I'm gonna put on a purple sock on my head. Let's see if it looks cool. All right. He's not wearing it here, though, so it must not look that cool. All right. I love Daniel Brühl, though, so I just think he's great. So look at this. So WandaVision, okay? So I love that he says, welcome home, Wanda. And I'm sure that Vision is, well, this is just all in Wanda's mind, so he's not going to have any ideas of his own. But if he did, he'd be like, I can't believe I worked so hard to look like a normal person in Infinity War, and you just like me as a robot. You like me as a robot all the time. I guess that's good. That's a great message. You didn't need to humanize yourself. Wanda's into robots, as you can see. And she's kept his robot form with all the face bling. All right. She seems to have reassembled the Infinity Stone. All right. Can she make a new Infinity Stone? I have a feeling that they might all walk out of the show at the end of out of her sitcom at the end of the season. Will he have a Infinity Stone smack in the middle of his head? That would make Wanda incredibly powerful, but she is that powerful in the comics. So he says, welcome home, Wanda. It's just so touching. And look at her reaction. She's like, you're not dead. Oh, I love it. And we're in a 50s sitcom. So she's created this idyll, 50s, 60s. She's creating this idyllic world where everything is, all your problems are solved in 30 minutes, you know, and everything goes great. It's a great idea. So this is Dick Van Dyke Show. So we're going to, I was like, could I possibly identify all the sitcoms this evening? I did, I think, except for one, but I even have a theory on that. All right, so she's so happy. Now look, okay, so it's so fast. It's good they were doing a shot by shot. Now I wasn't sure about this one, but this is the outfit she has on in a later shot. And so this is the Brady Bunch kind of. It's like a 70s kind of kitchen. Look how happy she is. I think it's gonna be the different stages of their relationship. It was of a married couple, and that's really cool too. All right, so look at that. Now, of course, we all geeked out when we saw this. Now, obviously it's a cheap version of the Scarlet Witch costume for some kind of Halloween episode on a sitcom, right? I just think, but you know what? As some of you have already said, she might decide to keep it when she walks out of the sitcom into reality, you know, back into reality. She's taken a bit of a break, which Scarlet Witch tends to do, but it's just really great. So this is like the Halloween episode. And I wonder, wouldn't it be cool since it's coming out this year, and it's obviously going to come out after Falcon and Winter Soldier if it came out around that time. But anyway, this is the one... This was the one sitcom set I couldn't identify, but it reminded me a little bit of like the modern sitcoms. And there's a sitcom that aired on ABC. It didn't last, but it was really good. It was called The Real O'Neills, and it was about a gay son coming out to his family in a school. But it got past that really quick, and it was just about his life. It was a very good show, very talented cast. It was on ABC. And of course, one of Wanda's sons, Wiccan, happens to be a gay character. So that would work really well to reference that. And of course, you'll see in a moment, Wiccan and Speed are showing up. All right, so then the next shot, where is that? Okay, so there she's shocked. So it's like the modern version that we've seen in a couple of her filming on set when going to SWORD headquarters. So she's kind of like, oh my God, this isn't real. It's all just a green screen. These shots look a little cheap, but I don't care because it's so amazing. So it's modern Wanda on the Dick Van Dyke set. Makes me wonder if they shot this the way they did The Mandalorian, where they project the sets and they never interact with that set. Let's keep an eye and see if they ever pick up anything out of the background. That'll make them like paper dolls. You know, can't actually interact with their backgrounds or dolls, you know, with their dollhouses, which would be a pretty cool comment. Like, we save money and make a searing commentary on Wanda's mind. I'm like, I love it. We all win. All right, so the next shot, this is really great. That, I believe, is the Roseanne set as a reference. These aren't identical, but they're very clearly referencing those shows. So Roseanne, which also aired on ABC, and she has a little bit of the Roseanne look there. I like also, Elizabeth Olsen is killing it here. I mean, her reactions and how she is doing like sitcom acting, and especially the wife sitcom acting, is like really incredible. There's one thing she does that I just absolutely love. So the next shot, so look at that. So they're married with their 50s, 60s wedding outfit. Look at him. He's so like got a paper. It's all like a paper, like, because it's like, it's Vision dressed in this crazy outfit. It's just fantastic. I love it. Look, back then you could leave your door wide open. It was fine. If he falls over one of the pieces of furniture like Dick Van Dyke, that'll be hilarious. Start watching TV Land or wherever, you know, wherever they air sitcoms now. So you'll know your stuff. I love that. That's it. Her like listening and stuff and like reacting, it's so adorable. And as many of you pointed out, she's pregnant in this sitcom. She looks great, wow. She's doing great body face acting, the whole acting, everything, every fiber of her being, she's doing a fantastic job. Now here she says, Vision Residence, oh, that's so great. You might want to read the Vision comic. This I think will be loosely based on that because Wanda's not a part of that. But I think it's definitely worth checking out. I'm clearly an influence here. So should we pull out and look at that? As I said, not the greatest VFX, but I don't care because the story looks so amazing. I'm thrilled, beyond thrilled. I'm sure all that furniture will fly out because it looks real digital. So the universe is expanding. They should be like, oh boy, at the bottom, I can't believe it. Now look, so there's U.S. agent. I thought we might get a full shot of him, but it's just from the back. That's, you know, Wyatt Russell, Kurt Russell's son. We've seen a full shot of him, but I want to see him in the show. But this is clearly an event. Oh, you look how America it is, and they're debuting U.S. agent. The kind of stuff that would make Captain America puke. He was very uncomfortable with it in World War II, and he certainly wouldn't participate in these kind of events today. He'd be like, people are being hurt. Some of them I care about. Some of them are just collateral damage. Captain America made a lot of excuses in my mind, but I loved his story. story so much in Avengers Endgame. We're pals now. Okay. Everyone's got the logo on, so this is clearly a government event. But they're debuting him on a football field, because it's America. I love it. All right. So Falcon the Winter Soldier, there they are together. Looks like their patience is being tested in some kind of prison. That looks like a prison facility to me. WandaVision. Oh, so there's the shot, okay? So yes, two binkies fly into the air. That, I believe, by the way, is the Family Ties set. Now, that actually aired on NBC, but it's currently owned by CBS, and CBS is willing to sell stuff because they don't really, they have a streaming service, but they're not going to do anything with Family Ties, so I think this is clearly a Family Ties reference. And as you can see, great costuming and hair makeup on this. This, I mean, wow, you know, they might get some awards for television in this regard because this is really impressive. So yes, yeah, so Wiccan and Speed are like, we're ready to grow up now and become our own characters. So look, the Loki logo changes, I believe, like Loki himself. As I've told you, I've heard a Kid Loki and Lady Loki will both be appearing on this show. Now look, here he shows up. They haven't really started filming yet, but I guess they filmed this little spot for here. So he says, I'm going to burn this place to the ground. And you're like, yeah, yeah, Loki, we've heard this before. He's like, you spent so much time in prisons. Why would this one bother you? Well, guess what? What does TVA stand for? I don't know. I can't believe Kevin Feige pulled this one out of the comics. It stands for the Time Variance Authority. Basically, copying Umbrella Academy. Umbrella Academy is like, God damn it! Even down to the lifetime job. Once you work for the time, the Time Variance Authority, the TVA, you work there forever. Now, this debuted in Thor 372, and even debuted in Thor comics in October 1986. And sure enough, has very Thor Ragnarok styling. Ah, this is great. So this is going to probably stick around with Thor. Love and Thunder has the same kind of motif. Thor is going to be very 80s, apparently, right? So I'm starting to wonder, is Owen Wilson playing Justice Peace? All right, so people who work for the TVA are called Justices, a little bit like Judge Dredds, and they even have outfits like that. Oh, Marvel does everything! Marvel is expanding so exponentially, there will be nothing left for the rest of entertainment at some point. And, you know, I think that point might be approaching sooner than we would expect. So anyway, Owen Wilson could be playing this character, Justice Peace. And, you know, Owen Wilson totally fits with the vibe of Thor Ragnarok with Jeff Goldblum, those kind of, that kind of casting. And also, just I would like to mention on a side note that the TVA has a long-standing problem with Kang the Conqueror, who also jumps through time. So I don't know if Loki will take the place of Kang in the MCU, or maybe he'll show up with Kang. They're like, we're both hopping through time. Let's be pals. Maybe Owen Wilson will be Kang. But those roles sound like something that Owen Wilson would be interested in doing. Maybe Kang in the MCU starts out working for the TVA. I'm very, very excited. So those sound like roles worthy of Mr. Owen Wilson. And again, we start to get a good idea of the tone that's going to stick with all the Thor properties at this point. Oh, it's amazing. I'm glad to see Tom Hiddleston back, though. And so we have these great little quick shots. That's wonderful. Everyone, look at everyone. This is so great. These shows all look amazing. I can't wait. It's gonna be like MCU movies, only 8 hours long, and more story and more detail, and better, more loyal to the comics. And apparently, maybe in some ways, even, dare I say, better. It's so great. So Disney Plus, the streaming service that keeps on giving. Disney's like, ha ha ha, and they laugh evilly, and you go, I don't care, it's amazing. All right, so what do you think? Is your mind sufficiently blown? Is this an even better spot than you originally thought? Share your thoughts down below. Thank you for going over this with me. Subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.